Hi everyone, Grant for the Flame Learning Channel. In the first three videos of this series, you learnt how the Explorer can manage your TimelineFX setups for VFX and grading within the context of the effects environment. In this video, you'll look at how the Explorer has been implemented in all the areas of Flame 2021.1. We'll look at MediaHub, Conform, Timeline, and finally how the Explorer works with Batch. Please refer to the video description to see the starting point for each section in the video. Now, when it comes to the Media Hub, the Explorer will only be available in certain browsing modes. For example, when you are browsing for files, this only refers to video and audio media, therefore the Explorer is not available. If you browse your Flame projects, the Explorer will be an accessible panel. You can access the panel via the main Flame menu or keyboard shortcut. This will also work if the preview window is visible. So to access TimelineFX setups or grabbed references from other projects, you navigate to the desired project and go to the workspace libraries. Here you will find a grabbed references library and a TimelineFX library. If you go into the TimelineFX library, you can access all your setups from this project. You can drag individual setups or a multi-selection of setups to the Explorer, and you can even drag entire folder structures with their contents. Now, this functionality is bi-directional, so you can also push setups into other projects and place the TimelineFX setups into the TimelineFX library. And similarly, if you were moving grab references between projects, the workflow is the same. However, you use the grab references library instead. Now, as a tip, you can also use the shared libraries to move TimelineFX and grabbed references between projects if you prefer that workflow. This can all be achieved with projects on the same workstation or across multiple workstations in a collaborative workflow. Finally, if you are browsing for archives, you can create a new archive or open an existing one and archive or restore to and from the Explorer, matching the interactivity of the media panel. So in terms of managing the TimelineFX setups and grabbed references, you have the same management functionality as your media. Now, the Explorer is also available in the Conform environment, allowing you to drag and drop TimelineFX setups in the sequence during or after the conforming process. This can be a big time saver if you're working on a series of programs that require consistent VFX or grading. Now, when looking at the Conform environment, there are a lot of tools on display at the same time, enabling you to properly conform as well as troubleshoot any potential conforming issues. This means the interface can get a bit crowded if the Explorer was just added to all these panels. This obviously won't be an issue if you're using a dual monitor setup, but for low resolution single monitor configurations, things would just get on top of each other. So taking that into consideration, there are two ways to display the Explorer. If your media panel is at full height, you cannot have the preview and Explorer visible at the same time. You need to disable the preview panel, and then you can enable the Explorer using the main menu or keyboard shortcut. This means that you can toggle the preview and you're able to choose what you see. The second way of working with the Explorer is when the media panel is not at full height. This stretches out the timeline controls, making it possible to see the Explorer and the preview at the same time. Now, admittedly, you'll probably use TimelineFX setups in the timeline or effects environments, but the functionality is here if you want. When working in the timeline environment, the Explorer can be displayed whether you're looking at the reels or the player. Just enable it through the main menu or keyboard shortcut, and it will stay on screen. Now, in terms of applying TimelineFX setups, you have the same functionality as the effects environment. You can drag and drop setups directly onto segments in the sequence, or you can drag and drop setups onto the viewport. Just bear in mind that if you drag and drop to the viewport or even double-click the TimelineFX setup, the effect will be applied to the track with the focus point. So as a tip, just ensure the focus point is on the correct video track to get the expected behavior. And as for creating TimelineFX setups from the timeline, you select the TimelineFX on the effects ribbon, and you can either drag and drop into the Explorer, use the context menu over the TimelineFX, or use the same keyboard shortcuts to save the setups to the Explorer. This is the same behavior as the effects environment, which is covered in the first video of this series. Finally, the player does have other panels to access various functions. You can get them via the player options pull-down menu or using Control 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Either way, it is not possible to have these panels and the Explorer visible at the same time. With the Explorer enabled, you would use the player options to toggle between the panels. And as a final point, the Explorer plus the player options are only visible with the single player. If you switch to the source sequence view, triptych view, or trim view, these panels are not available until you switch back to the single player. Finally, when working with a batch node flow graph, the Explorer can be enabled through the main menu or keyboard shortcuts, but it has a slightly different purpose compared to the other environments. So let's say, for instance, you are working in a node flow graph and you want to use a TimelineFX setup that you created in the effects environment. So with the setup saved in the Explorer, you can simply drag and drop it into batch, and it is automatically converted into the correct node with all the settings from the original TimelineFX setup. So you can start effects or grading in the timeline and promote them into a node-based environment. Please bear in mind that this workflow is unidirectional and you cannot save a flow graph into the Explorer. If this is something you need to do, then select your flow graph and create a BFX clip that can be added into the timeline and expanded out as a batch effects. Now, with the dual monitor configuration, it is possible to set up a number of combinations using the Explorer on the second monitor. Once you have set up your second screen, just go to the main general preferences and you will get the options to configure the layout to your liking. Hopefully, you have found these explanations useful, and let us know how you're getting on with the TimelineFX management workflow and the Explorer. Don't forget to check out the other features, workflows, and enhancements to the Flame 2021.1 products. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel and click the bell to be notified for future videos. Thanks for watching and hope to see you soon.